Hello, friends. Welcome to the Career Guru Podcast. I am your host, Steve Yanovsky. What a glorious day it is to start your path in a new career. Doors are opening here at the Boston Career Institute even as we speak. And I'm here holding the key for you. So tune in, stay sharp, and enjoy yourself. This is going to be great. Hashtag, let's career up.
Good day to you, aspiring career gurus and conversationalists all across the fruited plain. I am your career guru coming to you live, or pre-recorded rather, across the internet waves. It's great to be back with you once again. I'm so happy. I want to start off by first and foremost offering or expressing my gratitude to all of you who wrote to me for the outpouring of support. For me personally, I appreciate that very much. Thank you so much. Every text message, every email counts, and I'm grateful for all of it. It's time for us to answer some emails that have come in over a period of time, which require my attention. Before I do that, I'd like to say that I've already scheduled several guests who are going to be following up in the month of May in a topic that's very near and dear to me, and we're going to be talking about criminal offender registry and how to work around that if you're trying to get into a career. So that's going to be a few interesting discussions coming up in the month of May. Please stand by. Obviously, I will send out notifications please make sure to let your friends know for whom it may be of interest. Well, without further delay, let's jump right into the Guru Answers emails. All right. First email is from Janice from Providence, Rhode Island. And I'm going to read straight from the screen. Forgive me, the guru forgot his glasses. Okay. Guru, I've been trying to secure an internship after passing the national board exam. I should preface this that this is one of the folks that listens to some of my lectures about sterile processing, hospital sterile processing. So let me start again. Guru, I've been trying to secure an internship after passing the national board exam, but no one wants to speak to me or give me a chance. My provisional certification is set to expire. What do I do? Please help. Ooh, this is a tough place to be. So here is a person, Janice from Providence, who took the national board exam for hospital sterile processing or CRCST, Certified Registered Sterile Processing Technician, okay? And it is possible to secure this certification, but it comes in two flavors, if you will. One is provisional, and this is if you don't have the required 400 hours hands-on training in a healthcare facility, or it comes with a permanent certification for people who are currently employed or for people who actually complete an internship. So Janice here is expressing her absolute dismay in the fact that no one will speak to her. And I believe I've addressed this already in my previous podcast, but apparently, you know, this is one of those points that needs to be conveyed over and over again. It is nearly impossible to secure an internship in any corporation today due to the massive amount of liability that they take upon themselves when they take an intern. They would love to give people an opportunity and of course, to have some free labor, but they cannot do that because of so many restrictions placed on them by the powers that be. So to actually secure an internship requires almost divine intervention, which is why schools such as BCI exist, because we do go through all the required red tape every year to provide these organizations. For us, for BCI, they're healthcare organizations. Large hospitals, small hospitals, no matter what size they are, even private clinics require that we provide them with a full gamut of personal, professional liability, business liability. And all of these things cost a tremendous amount of money, something that no private individual can actually afford to do. But a school such as ours and others who participate, who take care of internships for students, do purchase this insurance, which costs many, many thousands of dollars per year and carries with itself millions of dollars worth of liability coverage. I tell you, this is not a pleasant thing. Whereas before, one could have contacted the volunteer department. And today, volunteer department is virtually useless for any type of clinical position. Private physicians are currently, for the most part, are affiliated with hospital systems. You may not even know that they are, but they are. They are working for all of these hospital systems. Even with a private physician, which is almost a dying breed, you still have to have something in place. For hospital sterile processing, certified registered central service technicians, CRCSTs, and endoscope reprocessing people, there's almost no chance. But to you, Janice, if you can hear me, and I know you will hear the sound of my voice, reach out to me again. Let's see what I can do. It's not an easy trek, nor is it free, but it is a possibility, and I can help you. Folks, I know that a lot of you are trying to do this on your own. A lot of you are studying this, and I salute you. It's hard to do without a school. It is hard to do. And it's not because people don't want to help you. They just can't. And the administrative side in hospitals is so massive that for you to reach someone who understands what you're talking about in the first place will require you to spend days on the telephone and emails until you find the right person who will, in the end, unfortunately, will say no. I know it sounds kind of gloomy, but there is hope. Reach out to me. You know the email address, podcast@bostoncareer.org. Call me here at the 617-383-6058, which is the main number to BCI in Brookline, and leave a message for me. I will call back. I will be able to try and help you as much as I can, but it's, like I said, not an easy proposition. This is one of those things that, for me, most of the things, no problem. It's just a matter of will and the desire to accomplish something. Unfortunately, this is one of these big stumbling blocks that you just can't get past without further assistance and without spending some money to do so. But, as I've said many times before, money, easy come, easy go. And I mean that, take that with a grain of salt, because I know money is hard to come by. But the reward is definitely there. Your return on investment will pay off in the amount of money that you will make in your new career. So spending a little bit of money and investing in yourself is going to pay off. Janice, I hope I answered your question. You know how to contact me because, you did that. That's why I'm responding to your email. So please write back and I'll be happy to help you move forward if you choose to do so. Okay. Next on my list, and folks, I received many, many emails. I just selected three only because they fit the general theme of the conversation that we're having today. A few emails which are similar in nature. So, Janice was just the first on my list. I receive quite a few of these emails. The next one is from Rose from Bellingham, Massachusetts. And I read to you, I've been working in Massachusetts as a medical assistant for years without a national certification. Now my employer is asking for this credential. I don't have the time or money to go back to school. I love my job, but ... Okay, once again, you see that there's a general theme developing about national certifications. Yes, my dear friends, it's both good news and bad news. A lot of employers are not just looking for experienced people or people who have skills. They're also looking for people who have the right piece of paper, because somebody in human resources decided to check off a little box that says all of our employees must hold national certification, or sometimes they say license, and they got really confused in most places because medical assistants don't have licenses in Massachusetts. In some states they do, in Massachusetts they don't. So they replaced it with national credential. Well, BCI works with NHA, National Health Career Association. Most of our people who graduate from the program, all of our people who graduate from the program are eligible to take the NHA exam. And because they graduate from our program, their likelihood of them passing this test is very, very high. So I want to tell you that we, for years now, have been catering to this examination and to NHA content. We have purchased their content. And we make the point of making this the centerpiece of our education in the medical assistant program. Now, having said that, you can look at their website. And if you just Google National Health Career Association, it'll give you the right email address. Okay. And you can see what what it takes for you to qualify to sit in for their examination. You can purchase the content from them and take the test. The only problem is that a lot of the test centers are dedicated to the schools that they work with for NHA. So, but it's not the end of the world. NHA will find a place for you to take this exam. NHANow.com, www.NHANow.com. If you log in to their website, it'll give you several options: get certified or renew your certification. Now, is it difficult to take that exam? I'm going to say that the exam without training is almost impossible. It is full of extraordinary information that medical assistants must know and that you must prepare for. So just because you think you have the experience where you went to school a long, long, long time ago, but you still remember everything, think again. It's like all the other things out there, like all these specialty tests out there today. It's not quite so trivial. As a matter of fact, I want to tell you, the same people who write this exam also write the exam for nurses. So it's an excellent way for you to kind of get your feet wet if you are considering becoming a registered nurse to take these exams. They are amazingly enlightening as to what kind of exams you will be taking. But Rose, don't feel bad. Everything is good. There are options. BCI is here to help you, and we can provide you with a pathway to this examination. So once again, contact me here. You know how to do it because you already wrote to me. podcast@bostoncareer.org. Sorry, Guru's a little bit off his game today with the URLs and email addresses, but you know how to find me. And the other way, you can start looking at nhanow.com, and you will be able to get your questions answered as to what kind of a test you can take. And you can certainly purchase the content from them. Not everything at this moment in time is in the hands of the school. So in this particular case, if your employer only wants national certification, there is a way for you. So check out the website or contact me and I will help you. Okay, so don't forget, we are all here for you. Guru's here for you. I'll answer your questions the best that I can privately. Now, last question for today. Not such a long podcast as always, but chock full of information. Donna from Boston is writing. Now, this is key, and I want to tell you now. I selected these three emails because one is for sterile processing, the other one is for medical assisting, and this one is for dental assisting. So Donna says, I've been a licensed dental assistant for well over 15 years. In 2015, my then employer helped me file for a dental assistant license, which became a requirement in Massachusetts. I just want to remind people. And I've been working with them ever since. Recently, my dentist retired, and I went to look for a new job only to discover that my dental assisting license is listed as OJT, or on the job training license. And the employers today are looking for an FTD license, which stands for formally trained license. What do I do? Once again, are you guys catching that there is an ongoing theme here? It's not an accident. I selected these emails on purpose. Okay, I did not include the well-wishers and so on and so forth, because I really wanted to jump right into this and be relevant for you. So I do want to tell you that there are indeed two licenses here in Massachusetts. One is formally trained dental assistant, or FTDA, and the other one is OJT. So people can tell you, oh, anyone can become a dental assistant. Yes, it's true. Just about anyone can become a dental assistant, okay? But if you go on the Board of Registration in Dentistry's Massachusetts BORID, B-O-R-I-D, website, you will find that there is a plethora of differences between the two. And you can also find out that, hey, if you're working as a dental assistant because you've had the experience and the dentist was negligent in not checking the right box or double checking to make sure that your license is the right kind of a license, and you're doing performing all of these skills, you see, the skills that a formally trained dental assistant can perform in a dental office is extremely long. But an OJT or on-the-job trained dental assistant is not capable of great many things. Or you can be capable of doing them, you're just not licensed to do them. And I want to tell you that the Board of Registration in Dentistry is very, very strict about enforcing these rules. Not knowing the law is not an excuse. That's going to be the first thing that they will tell you. Okay, dentists will be subjected to severe penalties and a very protracted process. Speaking from personal knowledge as to what that means to dentists, because I talk to dentists all the time. So how does one overcome this hurdle? Well, gotta tell you, there is no easy way of doing that. Well, there are several possibilities that you can do. I'm going to start with the one that you can do on your own. To become a formally trained dental assistant in Massachusetts, you either need to complete a training program which complies with the Board of Registration Dentistry rules and is approved by the board, such as BCI. We went through the entire process. The other way of doing it, if you have the experience but you haven't done this, is you can take the Dental Assistant National Board examination, which consists of three parts. So Dental Assistant National Board, DANB, D as in David, A as in Apple, N as in November, B as in Bravo, DANB. If you just Google that, I think it's actually danb.org. And these Dental Assistant National Board exam is three-part exam, which you take in three stages. One stage is radiology, one is infection control, one is chairside assisting. And it is a massive exam, okay? Massive. Hundreds and hundreds of questions. That's why you take it in three stages. And each stage costs money, I think about $140 each, maybe even more. I don't recall. This is something you can look into. But just because you have all the years of experience, but you lack the knowledge and the training, this exam is almost impossible to pass without the proper training. The good news is that there are plenty of training resources that you can purchase, and you can potentially take all three exams. Now, the first two exams that I mentioned, the radiology and the infection control exam, you can take just by signing up. However, the third exam, the chairside exam, requires, I believe, 2,500 hours of direct patient care contact. And for that, your dentist needs to sign off on your application to take this exam. So make sure that you do have a dentist that you have worked for or for whom you are currently working who will sign off on this application. This application is key, which will allow you to take the last chairside assisting exam. And once you get your certified dental assistant credential from CODA, you will receive CODA, C-O-D-A, I believe it's called the DANB, rather, who are credentialed by CODA, Council on Dental Accreditation, and Dental Assistant National Board is credentialed through them. It's a whole big to-do. So if you take this DANB examination and you become a CDA, Certified Dental Assistant, then by submitting this paperwork, your license in Massachusetts will now be listed as an expanded duty or certified license, which is a big, big deal in Massachusetts. Now, that's one way. The other way is to come to BCI and complete our training here. Okay, if you are already an OJT license holder and so on and so forth, there are some special considerations that you will have through BCI. You must complete the training in its entirety. Okay. there's really no way to get around that. And once you do that, you will have to reapply through us, and we will have to provide a transcript for you. So you will be able to file for a credential with the Board of Registration in Dentistry and become certified that way. I would like to caution all people who wish to enter this magnificent field. I love dental assisting in Massachusetts, and in general, it is a brilliant, brilliant career. It is a lovely place to work in the dental office. Not everyone can tolerate teeth, and you know, take it from me, I'm one of those people. But if you can handle work with a dentist hand in hand and dental hygienist hand in hand, you are providing a vital service. And the money that you make today is absolutely wonderful. It is an excellent career. It is an excellent job. Yes, you do a lot, but it is so gratifying, both emotionally, because you get to see a lot of happy people. People consider dentistries, oh my gosh, people show up to the dentist's office, they're in so much pain, and the dentist is so painful. No, it's not. Going to a dentist today is like going to a spa. As a matter of fact, a lot of dental offices today are half dental office, half spa. You know, so a lot of that is done over there. And it's no longer, you know, people sitting in these chairs like in some kind of a torture chamber. You know, no, dentistry is painless. Dentistry is wonderful. You walk out feeling so much better. You come in with pain, and 5 minutes later, you're no longer in pain. Or you have a crooked smile, and then they change your entire lifestyle, and you are a part of that. So if you really want to do something meaningful and beautiful and financially rewarding, listen, invest in yourselves. Word of caution, there are lots of programs out there who are charging people seemingly little money. Oh, yes, our program is so-and-so. You're going to get a dental assistant license. They just kind of quietly tell you that it's OJT license, and most people don't understand, okay? I get lots of calls here to BCI saying, well, how come your program is this much money, and how come your, you know, the other program is? Well, if you read the fine print in some of these other programs, and, you know, some of the colleges here in Boston have gotten in on the game here, and they're charging crazy money, and then what do you walk out with? An OJT certification. So be very, very careful before you sign on that dotted line somewhere, even from quote-unquote reputable organizations. Buyer beware, caveat emptor, as the Romans used to say. Buyer beware. Always look for stuff, okay? Now, I can tell you from our standpoint, BCI is approved by the Board of Registration in Dentistry, and we have offered this program for over 20 years. So much success, so many happy people, and all of you within the sound of my voice, if you're like Donna and you have an OJT certification, please reach out to us here. We will help you, okay? And those of you who really want to continue on in this field, I really suggest that you give us a call. It's a magnificent program, hands-on, vibrant instructors. Well, you know, enough for shameless self-promotion. These are the three emails I wanted to address today because they resonated with me. So much of this, these are not the only three emails. I can read to you emails all day long, but this stuff is key. So please look into this yourself. You can trust me, but you know, trust but verify is the old adage. Please do so. I gave you the website, the URL information. Find them, look into this, re-listen to the podcast, reach out if you want to, and we are here for you. And on that note, please stand by for notifications. In the month of May, there will be very important conversations about criminal offender registry reports and how to seal them, how to work around them. There's all sorts of stuff that can be done. Don't give up on yourselves. If you have loved ones who unfortunately have a little gig on their Cori form, don't let that stop you from becoming a success in your life. You don't have to work the fryer later forever. We're here for you. The guru is here for you. And on that note, I bid you farewell. May God bless you all. Stay safe, stay sane, and invest in yourselves.
Well, friends and aspiring career gurus, this was fun. Thank you for tuning in. I feel enlightened. I feel empowered. And I'm feeling grateful that we spent time with you. For more information about Boston Career Institute, please visit our website, bostoncareer.org. Boston Career Institute has three campuses located in Brookline, Massachusetts, Malden, Massachusetts, and Lowell, Massachusetts. Call our toll-free number, 888-383-6058. For questions, comments, and or information about our podcast, email me at thecareerguru@bostoncareer.org. The Career Guru podcast is available on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, our website, bostoncareer.org, or wherever you stream your podcast. Subscribe, stream, rate, and review our shows. Your rating and reviews help our show reach new audiences. Produced by PodPro Entertainment, The Career Guru lives within a network of podcasts located at podproentertainment.com. Hashtag the new radio. Looking forward to seeing you soon. All the best to you. My name is Steve Yanovsky. I am the Career Guru. May God bless you. Hashtag let's career up.